sisters and my brothers, we stand in faith before God and one another, listen to God's word, pray for our sister and our brother. Let us search our hearts, and in the stillness of faith, let us gather our prayer for Mario and Cheryl and for the church.
Let reading from the letter of Paul to the Ephesians. Follow Christ by loving each other as he loved you. Give way to one another in obedience to Christ. Wives, be subject to your husbands as to the Lord. For the husband is the head of the wife, and Christ is the head of the church, his body, his church, and the church is rather than Christ, so let wives also be subject to their husbands. Husbands, love one and Christ love the church, and gave himself up for us, that he might sanctify her and cleanse her by the washing of the water of the word, that he might present the church to himself in splendor, without spot or wrinkle or any such thing, that he might be holy without blame. Even so, husbands should love their wives as their own bodies. He who loves his wife loves himself. For no man ever hates his own flesh, but nourishes and tells it as Christ loves the church, because we are members of his body. For this reason, man can leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh. This ministry is a profound one, and I say that the members of Christ and the church, however, may each one of you not his wife, let every wife respect her husband. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. I have given them the glory you gave them, that they may be one. Please proceed. Once my fellow men all over the world, I did not like to remain on and more things I could come. The point is, everything about us is life is as any man God comes to us. Not for us to bear peace, and not for as that comes to us, but in flesh and love. The only thing that we can understand is the purpose of God. New relationships, understanding one another. That is how God chose to reveal himself to us in Jesus Christ. And it is a long, long story of God revealing himself to us through the whole salvation history, which is a human history. And in a very special way, Cheryl and Marty have chosen to let them have the opportunity for us this morning. By choosing the reading of Genesis about the creation of the world, about the deep human experience by God's creation, that man and woman should be living symbols and images of God's self for us, that we are not alone, that God is made to one another, and that Jesus came to reveal that God to us as the crown of the world. Our application from the knowledge of the world, God's wisdom and grace. So here we are on this morning, this beautiful moment, gathered by his friends and followers, to come here to let the lives and faith before God, covenant in Jesus Christ for a lifetime of living, loving, and nurturing, not only themselves, but all those around them.
Christ abundantly blesses your life.
above. He has already consecrated you both in baptism, and now he enriches and strengthens you by a special sacrament, so that you may assume the duties and love in marriage, in mutual and lasting fidelity. And so, in the presence of the church gathered here, I ask you to say your intentions. Cheryl and Mario, have you come here freely and without reservation to give yourselves in marriage? Will you love and honor each other as husband and wife for the rest of your lives? Will you accept the children lovingly from God and instill in them the love of God for your love of one another and of neighbor? Since it is your intention to enter into marriage, please join your right hands and declare your consent before God and His church. Mario, do you take Cheryl to be your wife? Do you promise to be true to her in good times and in bad, in sickness and in health, to love her and honor her all the days of your life? Cheryl, do you take Mario to be your husband? Do you promise to be true to him in good times and in bad, in sickness and in health, to love him and to honor all the days of your life? You have declared your consent before the church. May the Lord in His goodness strengthen you. Strengthen your consent and fill you both with all His love and His blessings. What the Lord has joined together, let no one of us divide. And I think in Christian faith, we should ratify this covenant. pray for all of us gathered here in this house of the church. Lord, strengthen us with his love and give us the courage to preach his good news. We pray to you. Father, we stand in faith in this day. We give you thanks for all your good gifts, for the gift of Mario and Cheryl's love. We ask you to hear the prayers and petitions we have made, those we have spoken aloud and those that remain in our hearts. And we ask you to grant them as always in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Please be seated.
Thank you.
Spirit, that they may become for us the body and the blood of Jesus Christ, our Lord. At which man we celebrate the Eucharist. On the night he was betrayed, he took bread and gave thanks and praise. He blessed it, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat. This is my body, which will be given up for you." And when supper was finished, he took a cup. Again he gave thanks and praise, and giving the cup to his friends, he said, "Take this, all of it, and drink it. This is the cup of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed and for all men and women, so that sins may be forgiven." Do this in memory of God. Let us proclaim the mystery of our faith. Christ has died. Christ has risen. Christ will come again. Father, calling to mind the death of your Son endured for our salvation, his glorious resurrection and ascension into heaven and ready for you, he comes again. We offer you in thanksgiving this holy and this living sacrifice. Look with favor on your church's offering and see the one whose death has reconciled us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by his body and his blood may be filled with his Holy Spirit and become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us, especially Marty and Cheryl, an everlasting gift to you, and enable us to share in the inheritance of all the saints, with Mary, the mother of the Lord, with the apostles and martyrs, Saint Joseph, our Lord Patron, and all your saints, on whose constant intercession Lord, may his Eucharist, which has made our peace with you, truly advance the peace and salvation of all the world, strengthen the faith and love of the Holy Church here on earth, your servant, Pope John Paul, our servant and Bishop John, together with all the bishops and religious leaders and the entire people your Son has gained for you. Father, hear the prayers of your family that have gathered here before you this morning, in mercy and in love, unite all your children, wherever they may be. Welcome into your kingdom, our departed sisters and brothers, and all who have left this world in your friendship. We hope to enjoy forever the vision of your glory, through Christ Jesus, our risen Lord, from whom all good things come. Truly, with me in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever. Amen. Now let us pray with great confidence and great hope in the words that Jesus gave us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread.
We're going to get some pictures. Kind of make a semicircle, I guess. Cheryl, let's just get the readers and stuff.
Oh, I read.
Oh, that's right, I forgot. Okay, I was already eliminating you.
Thank you.
Larry, yeah.
Larry read.
Oh, okay. Okay.
Beautiful. Okay, now look at me, everybody here.
Okay, come in, nice smile, everybody. Okay, all right, so second, that's beauty. Happy everybody.
Okay.
Thank you.
Great. Okay, now everybody that didn't participate in the ceremony that just came.
Everybody.
Yes.
Come on, Mom.
Good, you should be with your husband. This is their husband and wife, so we cannot divide. Okay. Even though she went to the ceremony.
Okay.
I will not.
That's good.
Okay, we get it. Okay. Is this good?
Yeah, very good. But let the husband come in front a bit more. That's it. Very good. Just keep like that. Very good. That's it. Closer, Mr. Robert. That's it. Now, Miss, turn yourself toward Mario. But turn yourself toward him. Mario, turn yourself toward your wife.
Okay.
Yes. That's everybody. That's good. Okay. Beautiful.
Okay, folks. Let's see. Okay. Onward. Here I come. Look at me here.
Okay.
Great.
I don't think there's any other pictures to be
done.
Do you think? And if you want any others, we'll have time. Do you think?
Oh, we can take some.
Yeah, Stan, we're going to come to the reception.
Green, yellow.